Hello, everybody! This is Punk Demon Neo, and welcome back to the Super Mario 64 playthrough. In our last episode, we did quite a bit, actually. We made quite a bit of progress. We started with 3 stars and eventually finished with 11. First, we went through our first secret level of the game, and there with our first slide level. Then we explored Womp's Fortress for the first time, took out another secret level, and then returned to Ba-Bomb Battlefield for our first 100 coin star. And now, we're gonna start off this episode. When I left off the last episode, we noticed that there was this ray of light shining into the lobby. And now to start off this video, we're gonna see what it's all about. Go into first person view, or close to first person view, and very simple, look up. Welcome to the Wing Cap course. Step on the red switch at the top of the tower in the center of the rainbow ring. When you trigger the switch, all of the red blocks you find will become solid. Try out the Wing Cap. Do the triple jump to take off and press Z to land. Pull back on the control stick to go up and push forward to nose down, just as you would when flying an airplane. So here is our first power up of the game. Like I said back in the first episode, Super Mario 64 does not have any of the traditional Mario power-ups. No mushrooms, no fire flowers, no starmen. Our first power-up of this game is the Wing Cap, which you could say allows you to fly, but it's more like an extended glide, because as you go along, you will lose altitude, and eventually the power-up will wear off, so you do need to be quick when grabbing these red coins. The flight controls aren't the best, and they're one of the aspects of the game, in my opinion, that hasn't aged entirely well. I think Banjo-Kazooie did it a little bit better, but go ahead and press the switch here. You've stepped on the Wing Cap switch. Wearing the Wing Cap, you can soar through the sky. Now Wing Caps will pop out of all the red blocks you find. So now all the transparent red blocks will be solid, and we can use the Wing Cap in whatever level it appears in. Here we go! And we also get a star for our troubles. Now we can have some fun. We're now going to return to Ba-Bomb Battlefield, and I believe in this episode, now that we have the Wing Cap, we can actually finish it. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm all for that. It's now time for Mission 5, Mario Wings to the Sky. So yes, you do need the Wing Cap to do this mission. There's really no other way to do it. So let's go ahead and get our shiny new power-up. And you need to use a triple jump in order to achieve flight. But there's another way you can get what you want. You can simply drop into a cannon. And the place we want to go is the floating island where we got star number 3 back in the first video. And I'm going to go ahead and grab a second Wing Cap to reset the power-up, because again, the power-up is on a timer. These coins here are in a ring formation. You want to grab the coin in the center of the formation in order to achieve this objective, and I'm going to have to fly back around. This one can be a little bit awkward, especially when firing out of the cannon at first, but it's really not that bad once you get used to the flight controls, and they do take a little getting used to. And just like that! Oh, I wanted to fly right into it! Dang it. Here we go. But a pretty cool landing nonetheless. Unlucky number 13. But that's about to change. Because now, ladies and gentlemen, it is now time to collect the final star of Ba-Bomb Battlefield. We are actually going to finish off this level. It's time for Mission 6, Behind Chain Chomp's Gate. This is a mission I referenced back in the first episode when I was talking about how open-ended this game is compared to later games in the franchise, where even if you're not currently on a particular star mission, you can still grab that star depending on what mission you're currently on. And this star is one of them. If I wasn't going by my rule of not getting the stars out of order, like if I was actually just collecting stars as I went, this star would actually have been the first one. We gotta deal with the big, intimidating chain chomp here, and we need to pound the stake that he is currently chained to. Do it three times, and... Freedom! And there's the star. Here we go! What can I say? Again, that's one aspect of this game is that at least with later entries like Sunshine and Galaxy, they at least separated the stars so you actually did have to sort of get them in their intended proper order. But with here, you can just get them in almost any order that you wish. And like I said earlier, you can get the star, you can rack up the stars very, very quickly. And I think just for fun, we're gonna now return to Womp's Fortress. And it's gonna be another Red Coins mission. Star 4, Red Coins on the Floating Isle. And like I did in the last episode, I'm also going to use this mission as an opportunity to collect the 100 coin star, but unlike last time where I kept it relatively uncut to sort of show off what to do, for this one I am going to do some cutting, except, you know, if I want to show off a relevant area like getting the red coin or doing something like this. Okay, I walked a little too fast towards the end there. There! Seriously, you gotta be careful tilting the control stick. It is a bit finicky, you know, when trying to move carefully so you don't wake that piranha plant up and you don't get, you know, he doesn't bite your head off. But there is red coin number one. And now let the footage cutting begin. There's red coin number two. And if we go off to this side area here near the friendly Babam, you can actually find a pretty nifty feature that's common in some levels. This is a blue coin switch. Ground pounded and a bunch of blue coins will appear. However, those blue coins are on a timer, so you need to act quickly in order to grab them. But if you manage to grab them, it will make collecting 100 coins much easier. And I would go as far as to say it might even be required. I mean, you might not get the 100 coins if you don't get those blue coins. So react quickly when you hit the blue coin switch. And we can use that thwomp to get red coin number three, and there's red coin number four right there. As well as red coin number five. Man, they're just handing it out like, they're just handing them out like Halloween candy. And punch! And there's red coin number six. Go for a little ride on that platform and that coin will be yours, and we shouldn't be far from getting the 100 coins. We can just take out these two womps right here. And yeah, we got this in the bag, baby. See ya. And there's our 100 coin star. Here we go. And now back to the star that we need to be concerned about. To get the last couple red coins here, you're going to need to kick down this plank of wood to create a bridge. It's like that scene from Atlantis, The Lost Empire. Hey, look, I made a bridge. It only took me like 10 seconds. I've actually not seen that movie. That comes from a time when Disney's animated features were kind of on the downslide a little bit. And there's our red coin star all the way back down there. Let's get there in style! I was actually worried for a second that I was gonna overshoot. ...123 stars is our high score. 123 stars. 123 coins is our high score. I don't think we'll be beating that. 123 stars. Yes, there are three extra stars hidden in the game that nobody knows about. And we're gonna go right back in. I think I'm gonna go ahead and knock off Womp's Fortress in this video as well. So we're actually gonna complete two levels in this episode. And it's only episode 3, ladies and gentlemen. Although, some of the stars we're going to be encountering later on in the game are not going to be quite so easy to obtain. So let's enjoy the early success while it lasts. Anyway, for this star, we're going to need to climb this tree to make this owl appear. Who's there? Who woke me up? It's still daylight. I should be sleeping. Hey, as long as I'm awake, why not take a short flight with me? Press and hold A to grab on. Release A to let go. I'll take you wherever you want to go, as long as my wings hold out. Watch my shadow and grab on. So we have a little bit of a gimmick here to get this next star. And yes, you do have to hold A. So let the owl take you as high as he will initially go, and we want to go to a very specific area, that cage right there. And we stick the landing! Normally I miss that landing a couple of times, but I landed right on the star. And let's go to the judges. 10, 10, 10, 9.5. Man, we are just gunning down these stars like there's no tomorrow. And now it's time for the final star of Womp's Fortress, Mission 6, Blast Away the Wall. And this one is pretty simple to get as well. We simply need to go to the area with the Ba-Bomb Buddy. And we're gonna need to use our head to solve this issue. Literally. I mean that in the most literal sense. This is what we gotta do. It seems so counterintuitive, but that's the idea. Now, there's nothing in that wall. I just did that to demonstrate. It's that wall that we need to aim for. And that should expose the power star. Now, it's just a simple matter of grabbing it. Unfortunately, you would think that maybe once the star is revealed that it will move to a spot where it might be a little easier to get. Nope! It stays embedded, partially embedded in the wall, and you have to go get it yourself. We gotta earn this one, folks. Here we go! Someone get me an Advil. I might need it. It's not every day you slam your head into a brick wall at escape velocity. And that boosts our star total to 18 stars, ladies and gentlemen. I almost said 8. That's... take that 8 and add a 1 to it. 18. And ladies and gentlemen, we have completed 2 levels in this video. 2 levels are already down. 3 episodes in, we've also got 4 secret stars. And we're off to a pretty good start here for the first 3 episodes. However, I'm going to make this one shorter than the previous 2. I'm going to go ahead and stop here, since beating 2 levels fully is probably a good place to do so. So that's a wrap on this episode of the Super Mario 64 playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw here, be sure to like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Punk Demon Neo signing out for now, and I will see all of you in the next episode.